Hello everybody, and welcome back again to part 6 of Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. Now in the last part we upgraded our weapon, we made sure we got a few extra levels under our belt, so it's about time we see if we can now take on the final boss. And before we do that, it's probably a good idea to take out a bunch of these monsters, because right now our experience with our weapon is still very low. And just getting a couple more points of experience in this weapon is going to make a really big difference. If you were paying attention just now, you could see that we're doing about 1800 or so damage a hit right now. So 1850, 1600, a little bit under. You'll see in a minute as we increase our weapon experience that this is going to make a big difference. See, 1600, 1900, so around there. Our experience right now is 43, as you can see. And I'm sure we'll be able to find a few gloves and other things in this tower. Oops. Wasn't paying attention for a second. And just, yeah, take out as many of these guys as you can, because every couple of kills you get more experience points with your axe or sword or whatever it is. My main concern right now is our armor. I'm not really sure if our armor is going to be able to protect us very well from the Kraken, which is the boss for this level. I'm pretty sure that the axe is plenty damage to take him out, but I don't know if I'll survive long enough. I'm just checking my map, because I have some old drone maps here for these towers. I'm just checking to see if I'm going the right way, but I think so. Like I said, I'll just take out as many of these guys as I can without taking forever, and then make my way to the boss. The end boss is actually straight north from here. But after we get through these few rooms, I'll go to the right a little bit. Just to see if I can pick up a few extra gloves and things like that, and kill off some more critters as well while we're at it. You can probably tell that it takes a little bit longer now to hit anything, and that's just because our experience is so low with this thing. With the dagger we were at a point where we could just walk into any monster and it would just hit instantly, but now it just takes a couple rounds. There we go, some gloves. And some more kills. Now if you've been paying attention to the hits, we're now up to over 3000, so we've already almost doubled what we were doing when we were getting started in this tower. We should be able to make it so that, that we consistently hit over 3000, and at that point I think we'll be ready to face the boss guy. I'm guessing about 100 or so experience with the axe should be enough. Already in the 3400s now, so we're definitely getting there. Come on. Yep. No, let's just kill these guys. Why not? I love it when you get a bag of gold that contains 0 gold. That's always interesting. So more skeletons out of the way, let's just take a quick look what's up here. Oh yeah, that's right, a few spectacles. Spectacles aren't the most useful things. You don't really need them for anything, but they can be useful, so we'll just take them along. Especially if they're lying around for free. You know what, let me just quickly see what our experience is now. 86, well, you know what? We'll get a couple more kills before we move on. I really would like to get it over 100 if possible. And I'm pretty sure if we follow this path, we'll end up back at the boss, because this is actually the only tower in level 1 that has a few teleports in it. So that means that if you keep moving to the right, then eventually you'll end up on the left side somewhere. And in fact, if you go down right now, it'll put you back close to the entrance. See, this is the room next to the entrance room, so yeah, we've been teleporting around a little bit. That's okay though. Get some more fire elementals out of the way. Might as well pick up this rod, even though we don't really need any more experience with the needle spell. I don't think we'll be using it for that much longer. As soon as we pick up enough gold, then I'm pretty sure we're going to upgrade to another spell. These needles aren't going to do anything from level 2 onward, even if we get plenty of experience with it. Go kill some more bees, might as well. Guessing we should be getting close to 100 experience now. Some boalisks, why not? Food. Food is really going to go quickly now, since we leveled up a couple of times. There's a demon's ring. I think the demon's ring improves strength if you use it. I'm not sure. I think so. Don't really need that. Though we could use a temporary defense item, probably, for fighting the boss. But our wisdom is so low that items really at this point aren't going to help us very much. If I'm not mistaken, if we go to the left here and then go straight up, we'll end up back at the boss room. I think we've cleared out almost everything there is in this tower, so yeah, we'll just go straight for it now. Yep, we're at 99, so we'll find a few more monsters along the way to kill, and then we'll take out the boss guy. At least I hope we'll take out the boss guy, because like I said before, I have no idea if we're strong enough to take him right now, or tough enough really. But let's keep him late. Oh yeah, that's right, I forgot to mention this earlier. This tower also has a lootable short sword. Might be useful to get that early on, just use it instead of the dagger for the first level, but it's not really that necessary. And since we're already upgraded now, I'll just use it, I'll just sell it. That'll be worth a few hundred at least. We'll get another glove, so we'll easily break 100 experience. Maybe even 120 or something. Yeah, well, you can wait. Oh, even another glove will definitely break 120. Oh, by the way, there's another trick which is going to become more important later on, and that is, like I said, there's times when in these towers you're going to have to do a lot of backtracking and walking backward and forward. So you might occasionally want to just leave one monster in a room. And the reason for that is that as long as there's monsters to fight, you don't use any food. So your food doesn't go down as long as there's monsters in the room. As soon as you kill the last one, your food starts going down again. So if you're going to do a lot of backward and forward walking in these towers, then yeah, just leaving one of them like this, you can just get through the entire room without eating anything. That's can be useful at times. Of course, we're still pretty low level now, so it's not that important. Okay, well, this is it. This is the final door before we go to the Kraken, which is the boss for level 1. Here's hoping we can actually take him. Twenty 20,000 hit points, so he's not going to be too tough, but he might just kick my ass. Oh no, looks like we're fine, we're fine. He does a bunch of damage, but it's nowhere near what would be dangerous to us at this level. And our reward is going to be a hammer. Now the hammer is a statistics item. So as you can see, our strength now is 85. And we pick up the hammer. We now have 95 strength. So these are extremely rare, these hammers, and there's a couple of other ones for intelligence and for dexterity. But they're really, really good because they increase your damage for any given weapon. Okay, that's it guys. We finished off the boss and we finished off pretty much all of level 1. There might be some stray monsters left here and there, but broadly speaking, level 1 is now completely clear. And we can start focusing on level 2. So that's it for my videos for today. I hope you enjoyed them. I hope you enjoyed seeing the boss fight. And well, thanks for watching and I'll see you the next time.